This playthrough is rated T for teen.
Greetings and salutations, viewers. Vauldemare back here with another episode of Star Wars Bounty Hunter. In the last episode, we went through Coruscant to find the Death Stick dealer, and he's told us where to go next. So we gotta find out. We captured the Death Stick dealer, then ran into. I did almost two missions. Finished a mission and then finished another mission. So we ran across the alternate bounty hunter that tried to beat us, but he was pretty easy. I don't know why he's been such a threat. But anyway, we're taking the information that we have to go on and going after the senator. Yeah, that's it. Anyway, I had to redo the last two maps because I forgot that it only saves when you actually press continue there. And I quit before that. Yeah, the game tells me, it's like, aren't you sure to save? I was like, oh, I thought I already saved. Nope. This is what I get for not paying attention. That's why my time completely is a lot differently. So anyway, let's continue on with mission number 5, to take down a senator, or capture a senator, something like that. As Coruscant is the center point for decisions affecting the massive engines of commerce in the galaxy, it is also a nexus of graft and corruption. Many politicians are paid handsomely to allow criminal organizations to carry out the shady businesses with impunity, and they enjoy a privileged lifestyle high above the city in opulent sky rises near the financial district. Kind of reminds me of Cloud City or Jetsons.
Ross, you see this? Security police. They're all over the place.
Trell suites at the top. It won't be easy getting up there.
It's never easy.
Man, you can really tell what the difference is between places. Like, when we were in the previous area, it was like kind of dark and dirty. Here it's like clear, clean. You know, I guess this is what happens when you're rich, huh? Alright. Well, we gotta make our way to the top of his abode. And of course we can't just walk in. Why wouldn't we? Alright, well let's that's probably a guard, I assume. Yep. You know, what I've done to like kind of fix the camera is basically try not to mess with it. Even if I really, really want to. Like, I wanna, you know, I really wanna like use the right analog stick or what, or control pad, whatever you're playing on to movement, and I'm just like, nope, don't do it. No. Oh, we got a. Looks like we got grenades or something like that. Huh. Okay, I don't know when we got those, but all right. Looks like we're not fighting standard goons now. Now we're fighting security. Security! There's not even anything here. Okay. Where do we have to go? Kind of looks like we have to go onto these buildings over here. That's what it seems like, anyway. Cause yeah, I see some groups, or I see some. Whoa! No! Almost fell off. Yeah, it looks like I'll have to jump down here or something. Like that. Oop. Looks like we got a target. Locked on target. Okay, I'm just gonna get down there and capture him instead of like, cause he's moving. So, and then I'll read his dial. It's probably one of those cases where I'll have to jump and then. All right. Let's see what he's all about. Lily Galt. Oh, he's only worth dead. Human male. Coruscant police force. I gotta remember to check if they're worth stuff, like dead or alive, more. Because I assume we're trying to get the most money. That's what we want. And I have only been paying attention to alive notices. You know what I mean? I thought I dabbed you already. Let's do that again. Sorry. Didn't finish reading it. Coruscant Financial District arrested a key defense and contract negotiation, resulting in a lost contract, Techno Union. And they don't want him alive. They want him dead. And then collect his corpse. Yep. Okay, so we're supposed to go in here. But yeah, I think I found out, like, last episode when I went through and trying to find that one person I missed in the mission before, not the previous one, but the one before that, which he was at the very end. You probably saw, if you were watching the video, you probably saw it there. I tied it at the end, but it was at the very end of the freaking episode. It was like in a spot I didn't even notice. Ooh, a Twi'lek girl. I'll admit, I kind of like the Twi'lek dancing girl, and I know that makes me a bad person, but I don't know. I always thought the Twi'leks were kind of Twi'lek women are always cute. I don't know why. I don't know. I think it's just a thing with exoticism or whatever. You know how people will sometimes like something that's not in their wheelhouse. where they're like, oh, you know, let's say you're surrounded by blonde women and then you find that one redhead and you're like, you almost fall head over heels for him, is because you've never seen or almost never see red-haired women, so it's just like, oh, wow, you know, that type of thing, but I don't know. Anyway, enough with my creepiness, let's keep going. No, I'm not a lonely person. Shut up!
Did you see that?
Anyway, all right, what? Well, you surprised me. Probably not a bounty, but nope, didn't think so. All right, let's keep going. I think that sound effect's in the original episode series, or like the original trilogy. I think the oh, I don't know if that's in any other media, but that sounds familiar. Then again, it's been quite a while since I've watched the original trilogy. I'll admit, that's definitely one of my favorites. You know, up there with like Spaceballs, Old Star. That's probably where I'm supposed to go. Is out this way. But let me check the other way just in case. Trying to think. I don't watch as many movies as I used to, so a lot of my favorites are like really old movies. Most modern movies don't appeal to me anymore. Even the ones that are actually supposed to be good. I don't know. I think it's just me trying to save money and just, of course, at the time of this recording, with things going down as they are, a lot of movie theaters may close or not, or permanently close down. But we'll see, I guess. So it might all go to. Might all go to streaming services after that. Which is kind of sad when you think about it. I think the movie theater was, I wouldn't say important, but it was kind of, I don't know if I even say necessary, but it just, you know, brought people together in an environment. It was a unique setup. I mean, most people's homes aren't designed for, like, optimal movie watching, but I don't know, if you get used to something, you think it's okay. You know. I do feel bad for, like, the mom and pop, the ones that are just common, like, movie theaters that aren't even that popular or widespread or franchised, you know, that just want to show old movies or whatever, or that one rare movie every once in a while, you know, they won't be able to survive what's going on. Get that bounty hunter. Well, what are you going to do? Okay, I didn't even get a chance to check it because it took too long. Yeah. I really wish I could just tell who the bounties are and the regular dudes are, you know. Don't shoot at me, dude. Oh yeah, there's also another way to change your like tags, is just by at least on this version, just pressing the directional pad left or right will switch it. The only reason I press and hold circle for this one is because, okay, I know he's a repeat because we didn't see him before. Yeah. Oh no, I think it's in the fourth movie we hear that voice. I think when they get blasted by the stormtroopers, when Darth Vader comes in like a boss. Stop. Man, those scenes are still cool, even this day. Although with the limitations on when the movie was made, they can only do so much, you know. Kind of like back in the day, if you watched the original Star Wars, like, lightsabers were supposed to be swords, not beams of light. So they were basically, okay, they were like light weapons, but they were in the shape of a sword, so they cut like a sword. I mean, if you watch the original version of Episode 4 when Obi-Wan cuts off that one alien's arm that's attacking Luke, it shows blood. It doesn't cauterize the wound. It cuts his arm off like a sword would. So I wonder when at some point... Actually, when at one point did they decide to just make them light weapons that just cauterize? Because I think that was even changed even in the midst of the original trilogy. Because of, like, when Luke gets his hand chopped off, it's not a clean cut. It's cauterized and just it's off. So I wonder if they just kind of made a decision to, they thought, oh, maybe not making an actual sword, but make it, like, a beam weapon of some sort would be better. I already checked you, didn't I? Wow, you go really fast for what? Okay, you're not anything important. You're a loser, and you'll grow up a loser, and your parents are losers, and your sister's a loser. Oh, no. Sorry. I kind of almost wish they kept the weapons as just like light constructs that just turned into swords. But I don't know. Now that the whole beam sword is now more so iconic now, that it would be crazy to go the other way. Anyway, and not that I have any problem with the beam weapon. I just, you know, keeping it a sword would kind of keep its mystical, you know, kind of like weird sci-fi, like, fantasy outlet, which was the original design idea of it. But, you know, ideas change, and I'm not one of those people that doesn't want anything to be modified or updated or retconned. It just usually has to kind of make sense. Those must be updated soldiers. Okay, can't go. Is there even any reason to have a weak spawn so I don't have to keep the finger of spawn too, so I don't have to keep paying attention to you. Oh! Yeah, I gotta love that, you know, LucasArts used the death screens that they used. These guys are... I'm gonna have to start paying attention more, because these guys are starting to do more damage to me. And they seem to be hitting more accurately, too. Yeah, the bosses aren't dangerous, but the regular dudes. Yes, sirree. Get me. Get that bounty hunter. Oh, no. Don't capture the bounty hunter. You know, one day I need to read the Bounty Hunter trilogy of books. Like, it's a really old book series that's supposed to be about, like, all the random bounty hunters you run across in the movies that get, like, they get named, but they either disappear from the story or they never get seen again. I don't know if you've got, although IG-88's made more appearances in canon and cartoons and stuff like the Clone Wars. I mean, I think he's even in the Mandalorian in a scene or two, I don't remember correctly. Although I don't know if he's called IG-88 at that point. I think it was called like another designation or whatever. I could be wrong. But yeah, there was like IG-88, there was the Transdosian bounty hunter. I forgot what his name is. I'd have to read the book. Then there's the guy with the bandage on his head. I forgot his name too. There's a couple others. But yeah, like they appear in the one movie because they're hired by the Empire to capture like Luke and them, or maybe it's Han Solo or whatever. But then they just disappear. They never take part. They never like in brief appearances or whatever. They're just gone. You know, so you're like, what was the point of that then? I mean, I know it was basically to show... am I supposed to hover? It was just supposed to show that the Empire was out gunning for the heroes, you know, that type of thing. But I don't know, just it's just kind of weird that they never popped up, even in a sense of, oh, they get beaten off screen, or not off screen, but they get beaten in a quick scene, like, or by the heroes or something like that. But nope, they come back to life in the extended universe, although I don't think that's canon anymore. Although really, with what am I rerunning around? I think I might be. Sorry, with me talking, I might have, like, lost track of where I was heading towards. Yeah, if you read the books, they kind of tell you what happens to them. Oh, Dengar! That's the guy, the name of the guy with the head bandage or whatever. Dengar. God, can't believe I remember such an obscure name as that. Am I going around in a circle? I might be... Did you say Empire Stone? No, you didn't say it. That would be weird. Okay. I've heard that voice actor before, too. I think he's done voices for, like... I think he voices, like, a Republic Admiral in the Clone Wars, I think. He sounds familiar. God, none of these guys are worth... Okay, so I'm not going in circles, because this area is new. I just have to be careful. I assume these guys are probably just straight up dangerous. I probably shouldn't be highlighting them at all. Nope. Huh. Yeah, that's the problem with like combat like based dudes, is that you're not sure if any of them are capturable or not. Okay, there's my... Actually, I probably should grab that before I die. So that way I get reset back in here instead. Okay. I was about to say, are any of them going to drop a healing spot? Potion? Pot? I don't know why I said healing pot. That's for D&D, not a... Or any game with healing potions in them. Does anyone else call it a healing pot, or is it just... I've heard that before, but... Maybe it's just me and a few other people. Although with D&D being going on the rise these days because of Critical Role and stuff like that, I wouldn't be surprised if more people are aware of stuff like that. I'm kind of glad it's more popular, but it's one of those things where it's almost too romanticized because by more grenades. It's too romanticized by Critical Role, and nothing against them specifically. It's just the oh, am I supposed to go in here? Maybe. It kind of looks like I am. So let me. Before I go all the way in there, now that I know. Okay, I entered through. Okay. I'm just seeing if there's anything else in here before I. It kind of doesn't look like it. It looks like I do have to go through. Because I can't go through that. Yeah, there's nothing there. Okay, yeah, I have to. Ooh, excuse me. I do have to go through this, so. I mean, maybe there's another way around. But this game is one of those games that has some exploration, but it is pretty linear when you think about it. Which I'm fine with. It's not a big deal. But anyway, yeah, the D&D's become so heavily romanticized that everyone thinks that all D&D games are going to end up being a game of, like, Critical Role, where it's got high production values and all this other stuff. It's like, dude, Critical Role is, like, hosted by a well-known voice actor who's been in the industry for years. And it's also that all the players are also voice actors who've been doing it for years, so they know how to emote and act and stuff like that. Can I actually drop down? No, it doesn't look. It looks like it's just a hole. So they know how to be in front of a. Well, maybe not in front of a camera. Although in this case, they are in front of cameras. They know how to be in front of cameras and how to emote and all this other stuff. So you can't really, you know, you can't really think of your whole game being like that. Now that's just a bit obtuse. You know? Really, I have to. Well, at least the flight isn't that obnoxious. But still, the fact that the game's trying. That's not good. That's not good. Okay, let's try that again. I was about to say, I was thinking, I was like, well, this is a bit weird of platforming, but maybe not too bad, and then all of a sudden I almost fall to my doom. Doom shall be your grave! Okay, so I need to get, wait, can you actually? Yeah. Oh, okay, I can. At least I got more places to climb. Whew, okay. Good. The only problem is if I fall... Can you keep going up? Because it looks like there's a... Well, I might as well grab the... checkpoint or whatever you want to call it. The hunters. Oh, or that's not a... Oh, no! 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 Dang it! And that's not a checkpoint. That was a... That was a heal station. So maybe I should cut to when I get back up to the top. I don't think you want to watch me doing all that, so I'll cut to when I'm back up there again. Alright, I made it back up to the top. I actually died off screen, and I felt, apparently in this game, if you fall after a certain point, if you don't activate your jetpack, the game just assumes you're in free fall and kills you, so keep that in mind. Actually, is there any secrets up there, or am I pretty much done? Okay. But yeah, I pretty much died off. Well, I mean, I died on screen. I'm just not showing if that's the word I'm using. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. But no, seriously, I did miss a fall and try to catch myself, and it took too long to catch myself, and I died. Oh, well. You get 5 continues, so it's not bad. Oh, you know, I haven't been checking to see how many bounties is. Oh, it only has 5. Must be a shorter level than I expected, but it'll probably take me the full 30 minutes just because of how much I've been doing, so... Nope. Is that another Tweelit girl? Very hot, dear. Thank you. Appreciate that. I know, I'm a bad person. Okay, so we have to go through that one. Okay. Well, with only some... I'm surprised I haven't caught at least another person by now, but... I don't know, maybe that's just... Either I missed a spot to jump and grab him, but... Like in the previous ones, if I end up finding them all just to... redo the... map off-screen and there's the checkpoint. Probably means that's where I'm supposed to jump, I bet. Yep. There's a couple of dudes over there. Let's see. Mill Timmer. Ah, another one who wants dead. Man, well, I'd be one of these Coruscant security officers to be killed. Coruscant Police Force, Republic Security Force, Coruscant Financial District, do your Corellian cop on the take. Took too much. Fry him, Sebulto. Any others around here? Oop. At least I'm not. Anybody posted there? Okay. For now that he's highlighted, I can always go back to him if I need to. Nope. You are not bounty worthy. That's where our ship was. Yeah, all that work just to get back up here. Or just to get up here. Okay, that's where we came out of, right here. Okay, I'm just checking to see if there's like any... I wasn't really looking for secrets. I was just kind of running around to see if there was a platform, but... Yeah, you can tell that the game wanted us to go there just because of the checkpoint's there, so it's like, oh, that must be an obvious, important spot to jump or whatever. I'm not seeing any secret stuff, too, so... Okay. Alright, let's... Okay. Slide, 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 slide. Whee! I guess the game knew I'd have just enough, Oh, right, he's worth more dead than alive. Yeah, definitely throws you off your game when you think you're supposed to keep everyone alive, but no, not every character needs to be alive to get the full bounty. And yeah, what's important to us is how much... Oh, do I not keep going up? Well, no, there's... Maybe I'm supposed to latch onto those ledges, because I'm not seeing anything else, so it's got to be that. Yep. I don't know if I have to climb them. I guess the game was designed with the rocket pack to be used quite concurrently with anything you're doing, which makes sense. I mean, it's the way you get around everywhere. Yeah, it's kind of interesting how most of the bounties in this place are based off kills instead of living. I assume I'm supposed to get to the top of that. Let me see if I can go in that door. Nope. Okay. Yeah, convenient though that the blah. Nuts. Well, at least I know what to do, so I don't have to. It won't take me forever to get back up there. Oh, whoops! I took too long. There we go. Just need that little jump there. Yeah. Too bad our rocket pack doesn't have. Oh, what the heck? Why does it keep doing that? It's like it's got a like. It's. What's the word? It's acts like it's not fully. The whatever, I forgot what it's called when it's like the full, like it's not fully put together or something like that. Like all the bits and pieces of it aren't programmed or something like that. So it my foot keeps coming off of the thing or whatever. But anyway, so I might be able to finish this with so few like captures. It will probably be able to finish this one within the time. Although we've only got so much time left, so we'll see. I might even have to, if I don't find that secret, I might even have to redo this level anyway, so. But now that I know it's not that long, with only, oh, I have to keep going up then? Oh yeah, I'm probably supposed to go up there. There we go. Probably none of you are bounties, but. Yeah. Kind of cool to just shoot them while they're tied up, you know, like where their back is turned and stuff like that. Okay, next level or next section.
Stop where you are.
Stop where I am. Why aren't you shooting me then? I'm such a. Wait, did you shoot a grenade at me? You did, huh? Oh, and there's a weapon for me to pick up. Oh. Bounties. Oh, that's a grenade launcher. Or something. Oh! I just can't get enough of that. Is that the Wilhelm scream? And, oh, what's the name of that other scream? It's like the, not Wilhelm, it's the one where he goes, yeah! I forgot what that one's called. There's a funny video online where someone does that with the TIE fighter, so they swap out all the, they swap out all the TIE fire noises for that scream. Yeah! It's pretty hilarious, and you can't help but chuckle at that one. Especially since it could almost work as the noises for that if you really wanted to do something with that. Actually, kind of makes me laugh just thinking about it. Actually, let me show off that thing. Kind of, yeah, it just shoots off grenade. Grenade will box and things. Uh-oh, looks like they're shooting them at me because I'm here. Ah, nuts. Okay. Note to self, none of these guys are bounties, so I could just straight up kill them all, or at least all the ones I've been seeing. Because, yeah, like, if I really focus, these guys aren't that hard at all, but since I was trying to check and see if any of them are bounties, you know, that's a bit of trouble. I think, oh, and they respawn too, great. Of course they do. Now I know that. Of course, hindsight's 20/20, isn't it? Oh, is there it now? That, usually most droids. The only droid we've had to capture alive is a C-3PO model. Or, I don't know if it's actually called C-3PO. Yeah. God, the freaking speed is messing with me, man. Look at that. Ooh. My head's swimming! Do you guys respawn too? Or maybe? Probably? Watch out. Grenade launcher. I really don't want to assume that they're all not bounties, but I'm getting a really strong feeling that they're all bounties. And I did check most of them, so. Yeah, and you ran out. I know you're a respawn. Just because you appeared at the door and nothing happened. Or just out of nowhere. Which I know a bounty would not appear out of nowhere. I might have to keep just going up. That might be why. You're probably respawning, aren't you? Probably. I think I've gone around in circles, so I probably have to keep going forward. Nope. And sometimes the backpack. Ah, whoa, what the? What in the name of the Force? I think I have to keep going up. Yeah, it kind of looks like I have to keep going. I just keep checking the doors to see if there's like any secrets or anything like that, but probably not from what I'm feeling. It's like a blaster rifle. If I wasn't looking for bounties, this would be coming by a lot faster. Oh, maybe you're a... Actually, you're probably respawned. Ah, nuts. Golly. Jeez, these guys are just... Ah! They just start me off in the middle, guys. Okay, so I can just skip you guys since I know. So I basically have to get to the top without... Yeah, bosses aren't difficult, it's just the spawning of a hit. Oh yeah, what time? Oh, yeah, we're almost at the 30-minute mark. I might just keep playing, just till I finish the level. Or, yeah, finish the mission, anyway. Oh, whoa, what the? Whoa, what happened? Game? Is this the PS4 remake's fault, or is it actually the PS2 one was this glitchy? I'm almost dead again. Anyone gotta drop health? No? Cool. Thanks, game. Guess I do have to attack. Or take them all out before, otherwise I'm gonna get wrecked. I'm gonna get really, really wrecked! Dang it! I don't want to redo this whole thing again just because, you know, the game just is not treating me nice. They're treating me nice, guys. They're stopping. These guys are getting more and more heinous, that's for sure. I gotta focus on taking guys out long, one hitting upwards, otherwise I won't even have any healing things available by the time I actually get up to the top. These guys are dropping healing things. They're right drunk on them all the time. And now I'm like hardly getting any. Oh, none of them are dropping. Thanks, Greg. For being so nice to me. We're at the top again, right? Okay. Let me... course he's not. Might just have to call it a, because I don't want to lose all my lives by the time I get where I'm supposed to be. Oh, am I supposed to keep going? Oh, I am supposed to keep going. I don't want to assume anything, but it makes me think strongly that none of these guys are bounties. I'm not gonna say that. Kill my bounty. Most of them are respawning at this point. So. Nope, nope. Jesus Christ, come on. Okay, where do I need to go? Oh, there's a thing up there. Uh-oh, but who's shooting at me? Oh, there you are, okay. I wasn't sure who was attacking me there for a second. Probably should assume these guys are respawns too. Or not, yeah. Sorry. Oop. Let's grab that. So I know which door I have to go through now. I just have to go back. Oh no, there's multiple doors out of here. Did you say burn? Reminds me of Flame Hineyard or something like that. Oh, maybe that's the door I'm supposed to go, because that's the checkpoint. Something, I forgot how it went. It was like one of the most annoying bosses in gaming history. There's a character called Flame Hineyard in, like, was it Mega Man 7? Actually, that one had a lot of annoying voices, frankly, to tell you the truth. Like, just, they always said, I mean, I don't mind characters talking and saying stuff during combat or whatever, you know, just there's some humor into it, but it was just, like, obnoxious. Like, it just wouldn't stop. You know, like, turn off, like, maybe they do voicing the first time they do stuff and get hit, but then they don't turn it off after the fact, you know? Like, it just keeps going. Am I supposed to... Was it this one I countered at? Well, the camera's clearly saying I need to jump, and... Okay, I just need to climb. Did any of the other doors... I don't think so. Well, like I said, if I find them, I'll show them on him. At the end of the episode. I've noticed Jango doesn't say, I noticed Jango doesn't say much, but I guess that makes sense. He's supposed to be solitude, only talks when he needs to be talking to and all that other fun stuff. Let's see if there's any secrets or anything over here before you, because the ladder is the obvious place, but, nope. Are you a secret? Oops. Yes, you are. Oh, yeah, most of these guys are wanted dead. Most of these security officers are wanted dead or alive. You're coming with me, except in this case, dead. Oh, no, alive is... Never mind. Lyle Rooker. Human, male, unknown, Coruscant, defaulted on a generous loan for the bank. Oh, that's probably why they don't want to have him killed, because otherwise they won't get their money. Jeter's bar owner. Well, he just didn't pay his tab? That's pretty much what that says to me, anyway. So 3 out of 5. Oh, and there's a secret. We must be at the end of the level then. Because I've noticed most of the secrets tend to pop up like at the very end. So it looks like we missed two guys somewhere along the way. I'm assuming we missed two guys. I mean, we still have... The game hasn't done the whole continue thing yet, so... Oh, I guess that's the other way to go around. Because I assume there's another ladder over here. Yep. Okay. I feel like we're pretty close to that, because I think we're almost at the top of the... Yeah, like, that's the top right there of where we're supposed to go, so... Oh, no! Gee, many crying games. That was not cool! That is kind of nice of the game to actually purposely, at least in some areas, move the camera to specifically go, hey, you need a jetpack up here. Now if it just grabs it... There we go. I mean, the game definitely ain't perfect, but at least it tries in some areas to, I'm not supposed to, like, there we go. Actually, I'm not supposed to be trying to climb up, because I'm supposed to hang on, because otherwise, yeah, it keeps wanting to climb up. That way I'm, like, hanging on or whatever. Okay. Whew. Senator.
Please, don't kill me! Anything you want, name your price! Komari Vosa. Where is she?
Vosa? I don't know any Vosa!
You were saying?
Sepolto, our supplier, he asked me to move a new kind of death stick for the Bandogora. I don't know anything more. He knows. He's on Malastar. Ah, let me go!
Release the senator, or we will open fire!
Do what he says, bounty hunter.
Release him! Now!
As you wish.
No, wait!
Blast him!
Thanks, and goodbye. One day I need to show, I need to show, Mass Effect one of these days. No, we're not quite done with the level yet. We dropped the frickin' senator, and now we're being attacked by a security, chopper, or whatever you want to call it. Get to the chopper! Wouldn't that suck if some of the guys I just killed were bounties? Nope. Because we're not quite done yet. Until the level says I'm over, I'm assuming there's probably still some bounties somewhere. Oh, we got a, we need more of those anyway. Is it just me, or is Jango's pants look like they're like poofy Levi or something, Levi pants or something like that? Well, when they made a lot, I mean, if you were making costumes for like a, I mean, they're based off of the man, Jango, Boba Fett's like outfit, which is obviously stuff they had to scrap together, you know. And I feel like there's no. What? Oh, come on! You guys are dicks. Probably gonna have to redo this section again. Did he shoot a missile at me or grenades? Oh my god. Talk about it. One last continue. Hopefully I'll be able to. Okay, I assume I'm supposed to take out the security security vehicle or whatever you want to call it while surviving all these guys. Nothing here. I assume I need to beat destroy. Oh, bah! I assume I just need to beat it. Your design is pretty similar to that Rico ship or whatever it is. God, these. It ain't you guys doing a lot of damage to me. It's the frickin'. Because I'm almost. Like I said, I was on my last continue. Oh, that's not good! I should be using the grenades, frankly. Tell you the truth. Wait, is he even doing any damage? It's not letting me switch targets. Stop it! Game! Oh my god, game. Unless I'm supposed to, like, get on that thing, but I don't think so. Oh, that's not good. It's freaking highlighting someone else instead of the. That. I have no idea if I'm supposed to actually. I don't know. Oh, that's all I was supposed to do, is just shoot the crap out of it. Well, that was close. Woo! Almost lost my last life to that. And the fact that that ship wasn't the hard part, it was the people attacking me or whatever. So, it looks like I missed out on two of them, so I'm gonna have to redo the level, and I'll show you where those last two were.
Hurry!
Kind of think of where they're probably in a space that I skipped over, because like that last guy I got before I ended the level, he was in a place that was just all on its own or whatever. So anyway, I'll tack that on at the end of this episode, but looks like we didn't get everything we needed from the senator, so I have to kind of find another way to tackle our hunt. How will we find this hunt? Find out next time in chapter 3 of Star Wars Bounty Hunter. Thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.